Hello, dear students. Today we are going to begin lesson number 17, conjunctions. Dear students, as we know that there are 8 parts of speech in English, and this is also one of them. But before we go into this thing, let's know the definitions. Though you might have already started in your previous class, yet we are going to see once again. So if I ask you the definitions, what will you say? So, you might either say conjunctions are words that join, okay, one more words, phrases or sentences. So, what is the function of conjunction? The function is to join words, phrases or sentences. Just remember this one. And here, I have just divided the conjunctions into two. You can see the first one, okay, coordinating, and the other side, okay, correlative. So what are coordinating conjunctions? Here you can see the short forms, okay, which is known to you. Fan, okay, fan boys. F stands for for. A stands for and. N stands for nor. B stands for but. And O stands for or. And Y stands for yet. And S stands for so. So these are the examples of coordinating conjunctions. Let's see the examples of correlative also. So correlative, which is always used in pair, okay, and this is single. So coordinating conjunctions are always used in single, whereas the other side, correlative, are always used in pair. So the first one is both and, not only but also, either or, neither nor, whether or. So these are few examples of the correlative conjunctions. Let's now come to page number 105 from your book. Let's see some example. I go to library. I often go to library, comma, for I love to read. For I love to read. So here conjunction is being used. Let's see the next set of sentence. The manager is strict. The manager is strict. See, but, what is that? But understanding, but understanding. So before the, what to say, coordinating conjunctions, comma is being placed, and then we write the coordinating conjunctions. There are so many other examples, like the other one. We could not go out. We could go out or stay at home. So or, okay, if there is or used, so that tells us that there are some options. I don't know swimming, yet I like to visit beaches. It was so cold, so I had a cup of coffee. So these are, what to say, the examples which I already told you. Now we will talk about page number 106. Let's see the exercises. Question number A. Fill in the blanks with appropriate coordinating conjunctions. Let's see the first one. Jane Eyre was a small girl. I'm erasing all this. Jane Eyre was a small girl, dash, for dash, okay, we have a comma over here. She had a sense of right, she had a sense of right, dash, wrong. She had a loving uncle. शी हैड अ लविंग अंकल कॉमा डैश हर आंट हेटेड हर आंट hated her. So in this blanks, what do we have to do? We just have to put appropriate coordinating conjunctions. Let's begin. Jane Eyre was a small girl, yet she had a sense of right and wrong. Right and wrong. She had a loving uncle, but her aunt hated her. So this way you are going to do it. Let's just move on to the second one also. There it says, Jane's uncle made his wife promise that she would take care of the girl, but she did not keep her promise. Here we have a little change, I think. Let's see. She had a loving uncle. She had a loving uncle. So her aunt hated her. So you can write so also. And the next options, where we have the second one, write but. And third one, she put Jane in an orphanage. There Jane became sickly and weak for the girls in the orphanage were not given enough food. So dear students, this way you are going to do question number A. Now let's move on to the other side, page number 107. So the first one, as I already told you, Jane Eyre was a small girl, yet she had a sense of right and wrong. She had a loving uncle, so her aunt hated her. So instead of here I wrote better to write so. Question number B. Complete the sentences with the correct options. So one, there's Komal. Dash Anirudh participated in high jump. So let's see, we have two options given here. So the first one is that neither nor, whether or. So we'll go for the first one. Neither Komal nor Anirudh participated in high jump. Let's see the next one. Suman is jolly, friendly. So within the options we have whether or both. So we are going to write both. Suman is both jolly and friendly. Number three we have dash Kamya and Ramya go to the same school as me. Within the bracket we have not only but also whether or. So it says not only Kamya but also, we'll write but also Ramya go to the same school as me. So dear students, I just ask you to do these questions, question number A and B in the copy. And we have one more exercise that also you can do you just have to find out the correct pair of the words that are being used. Let's see, I just tell you this one. Question number C. Join these pair of sentences with the conjunctions given in the box. Some of the conjunctions can be used twice. So I'll just tell you the first one. You are going to write both the sentence. Work neatly. Work neatly. And don't work at all. Don't work at all. So the answer will be either. Either work neatly or don't work at all. So this is the first one. And the next one, my parents are proud of me. My friends are proud of me. So we can write here. My parents, parents, here it is, both, let us start, both my parents and friends, both my parents and friends are proud of me. So you're going to write the sentence as it is given in the book, My parents are proud of me, my friends are proud of me. So the answer will be both my parents and friends are proud of me. So this way, please write this exercise also. In case of any difficulty, just let me know. Thank you.